Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. So for today I am doing this rose out of Hannah Carlson's book Seasons, and it's going to be a little bit different from my norm. I titled it Gothic Rose because I'm doing blacks and grays and the rose is red. So here I'm just applying some watercolors. I'm only using black and white. I used two blacks just because I had two different blacks and I kind of wanted to test them out to see if they were a little bit different, but they ended up being pretty much the same. So yeah, just use your black and a white and then we'll mix them together in some areas and make grays, different shades of grays. And I'm also using these Coliro Pearlcolors watercolors. Now I point to the red and I start to activate the red, but I actually don't end up using it. I thought that I might, but I only end up using that blue silver color down on the bottom row there. So here I'm just going ahead and activating those watercolors and just getting those ready to use. So I will be popping in again towards the end of the video when I am applying all of the accents and everything to kind of explain what I'm doing there. Thank you. kind of wish that I hadn't, but I am filling in that little rosebud area with black. So I'm just letting you know right now, you might want to keep it open to do a little red rosebud color. I kind of wish that I hadn't filled it in, but you know, hindsight's 20/20. So I just wanted to give you a little heads up about that.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, so here I started using my little blender stick just to try to get into some of those tight places there along the spine of the book. But I was having trouble with the sponge on the end cooperating. So I just ended up using the big blender all around the edges of the paper.
Thank you.
Okay, so here I'm using this Wink of Stella glitter brush pen in red. I just wanted to add like a subtle sparkle to some of those areas in the rose there, but it didn't really do much. So, it's not a necessary step by any means. And then you will see me using Glossy Accents, and I'm using those to apply kind of a water drop or dew drop effect to some of the areas in the rose petals. And so, yeah, you can't really see them very well on camera, but they look pretty nice in person. So that pretty much wraps it up for this page, and I thank you all for sticking around with me for a little bit, and I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!